First of all, I will introduce myself. Myself is a Dr. S. A. Khairnath, head of the Department of Botany. I welcome all the students of SYBSC at your new class. This is what an introductory lecture about the syllabus. Since last year, you are going to attempting under the CBCS pattern, that is credit based choice system. In the last year at FYBSC, you appeared under the credit based system. For this year also, for you people, the credit based choice system is adopted, and for SYBSC also you have to follow the credit based choice system. Under credit based choice system, you have to take three subjects and one language. You have to choose one language and three subjects of your from your last year. I am going to teach you the one of the paper of botany. That way, for SYBSC semester third. Why it is a semester third? Because your FYBSC semester first and semester second is considered. And this year for SYBSC you have to, this is a semester third and next semester will be a semester fourth. For your semester fourth for the botany, you have a two theory papers and one practical course. Your theory papers for that are the compulsory thing. For semester third, the theory paper BO 231, that is what going to teach to you by myself. And another second course, that is a BO 232. The title of this course is plant physiology, and this will be taught you by the another teacher of botany. And on the basis of both these courses, you have a third course, that is BO 233. This third course is for a practical based on paper first and paper second. So for this year, for this semester, I am going to teach you the paper first. The title of paper is Taxonomy of Angiosperm and Plant Ecology. This your paper first includes, or for this paper you have allotted a 2 credits. Total you have allotted 2 credits of 30 lectures. It means 1 credit is equivalent to a 15 lecture. So for your credit first, you have to learn Introduction to Angiosperm Taxonomy. You have to learn the Introduction to Angiosperm Taxonomy. That is what introductory part. Then systems of classification. Then you also have to learn or study some families, study of families. Under this heading, you have to complete the credit first. For introduction, there is a weightage of 2 lectures. For systems of classification, there is a weightage of 5 lectures. And for study of family, there is a weightage of 8 lectures. So in this way, the total is of 15 lectures. These 15 lectures you have to do, or you have to attempt for obtaining the credit first. or this will be allotted a credit first. For credit 2, you have to learn botanical nomenclature. Under credit 2, you have to learn the botanical nomenclature. Then you also have to learn introduction to ecology. Then you also have to learn ecological grouping of the plants. Ecological grouping of the plant. So, for this credit 2, botanical nomenclature has a weightage of 5 lectures, whereas introduction to plant ecology has a weightage of 6 lectures, and ecological grouping of the plant has a weightage of 4 lectures. In this way, the total you can complete the 15 lectures for credit 2. These are what the syllabus of your theory for the paper first, taxonomy of angiosperm and plant ecology, including the 30 credits. So we have to learn these 30 credits for the paper first. All papers have a 30 credits. So under these 30 credits, you have to learn all these different syllabus for your paper first. Under introduction of angiosperm taxonomy, you have to see the definition of taxonomy, scope of taxonomy, objectives of taxonomy, what is the importance of taxonomy. Then you also have to learn about the exploration, description, identification, nomenclature, and classification, and concept of system with brief historical view. This thing you have to learn under the introductory part of the taxonomy of angiosperm. Then you have to learn the systems of classification. There are different systems of classification are developed at a particular time. So you have to learn the different systems. Basically, there are three systems of plant classification: artificial, natural, and phylogenetic. You have to learn that systems of plant classification. And additionally, you have to learn one of the modern system of plant classification, that is a APG system in brief. Then study of plant families. You have to study the plant families. Under this, you have to study some families of Polypetalae according to Bentham and Hooker system, some families of Gamopetalae, and one family is from Apetalae or Monoclamidae, and one family is from Monocotyledon. In this way, you have to learn eight families. Under this, you have to learn the eight families with respect to their morphological, reproductive characters, classification, floral diagram, floral formula, and common plants belongs to that particular family. This is what about the credit first. In credit second, under botanical nomenclature, you have to get understand the concept of botanical nomenclature. What is the history of botanical nomenclature? Then you have to learn what is the binomial nomenclature system of angiosperm, identification and nomenclature. Then you have to get understand the course of international botanical nomenclature. That is what briefly said as the ICBN, International Course of Botanical Nomenclature. What thing is described in the botanical nomenclature that you have to study under the botanical nomenclature. So These four topics, introduction, systems of classification, studies of family, botanical nomenclature, are belongs to taxonomy of angiosperm. This is what the first part of your paper first. Then second part of your paper first, that is what a part of plant ecology. So under that you have to first see the introduction to plant ecology. Under introduction you have to see what is definition, what is the concept of ecology, what is the scope, why the ecology is an interdisciplinary approach, what is mean by atoecology and what is mean by scene ecology. Then again, you have to learn species diversity, types of diversity, methods of vegetation sampling, genetic diversity, species diversity in detail, ecosystem diversity in detail, and one topic you have to learn under this, that is a hot spots of India, biodiversity hotspots of India. These things are included in under the introduction to plant ecology. Then in the last point, ecological grouping of the plant. Plants are also grouped ecologically on the basis of in which environments the plants are growing, and according to different types of ecological groupings of plants are made. So under this point you have to learn the ecological grouping of plants with respect to their adaptations, external and internal adaptations, and under this you have to learn about the four ecological groups of plants, and that are what? Hydrophytes, mesophytes, xerophytes and halophytes. The name itself includes the environmental condition. Hydrophytes means plants growing in a plenty of water. Mesophytes means plants are growing in an optimum condition of environment. Xerophytes means plants growing in a xeric condition. And halophytes means plants are growing in a marine or salty situation, salty mud or marine environment. This is what ecological grouping of the plants. So in this way, you have to complete your this course of taxonomy of angiosperm and plant ecology for the semester 3rd of SYBSC. So this is what a introduction about the taxonomy of angiosperm and plant ecology. Okay, this is a introduction to you with respect to your syllabus of botany and credits. Thank you. First of all, I will introduce myself. Myself is a Dr. S. A. Khairnath, head of the Department of Botany. I welcome all the students of SYBSC at your new class. This is what an introductory lecture about the syllabus. Since last year, you are going to attempting under the CBCS pattern, that is credit based choice system. In the last year at FYBSC, you appear under the credit based system. For this year also, for you people, the credit based choice system is adopted, and for SYBSC also you have to follow the credit-based choice system. Under credit-based choice system, you have to take three subjects and one language. You have to choose one language and three subjects of your from your last year. I am going to teach you one of the paper of botany. That way, for SYBSC semester 3rd, why it is a semester 3rd? Because your FYBSC semester 1st and semester 2nd is considered. And this year for SYBSC you have to, this is a semester 3rd and next semester will be a semester 4th. For your semester 4th for the botany, you have a two theory papers and one practical course. Your theory papers for that are the compulsory thing. For semester third, the theory paper BO 231, that is what going to cut or teach to you by myself. And another second course, that is a BO 232. BO 232. The title of this course is Plant Physiology, and this will be taught you by the another teacher of botany. And on the basis of both these courses, you have a third course that is BO 233. This third course is for a practical based on paper first and paper second. So for this year or this semester, I am going to teach you the paper first. The title of paper is Taxonomy of Angiosperm and Plant Ecology. This your paper first includes, or for this paper you have allotted a 2 credits. Total you have allotted 2 credits of 30 lectures. It means 1 credit is equivalent to a 15 lecture. So for your credit first, you have to learn Introduction to Angiosperm Taxonomy. You have to learn the Introduction to Angiosperm Taxonomy. That is what introductory part. Then systems of classification. Then you also have to learn or study some families, study of families. Under this heading, you have to complete the credit first. For introduction, there is a weightage of 2 lectures. For systems of classification, there is a weightage of 5 lectures. And for study of family, there is a weightage of 8 lectures. So in this way, the total is of 15 lectures. These 15 lectures you have to do, or you have to attempt for obtaining the credit first. Or this will be allotted a credit first. For credit 2, you have to learn botanical nomenclature. Under credit 2, you have to learn the botanical nomenclature. Then you also have to learn Introduction to Ecology. Then you also have to learn ecological grouping of the plants. Ecological grouping of the plants. So, for this credit 2, botanical nomenclature has a weightage of 5 lectures, whereas introduction to plant ecology has a weightage of 6 lectures, and ecological grouping of the plant has a weightage of 4 lectures. In this way, the total you can complete the 15 lectures for credit 2. These are what the syllabus of your theory for the paper first, Taxonomy of Angiosperm and Plant Ecology, including the 30 credits. So we have to learn these 30 credits. for the paper first. All papers have a 30 credits. So under these 30 credits, you have to learn all these different syllabus for your paper first. Under introduction of angiosperm taxonomy, you have to see the definition of taxonomy, scope of taxonomy, objectives of taxonomy, what is the importance of taxonomy. Then you also have to learn about the exploration, description, identification, nomenclature, and classification, and concept of system with brief historical view. This thing you have to learn under the introductory part of the taxonomy of angiosperm. Then you have to learn the systems of classification. There are different different systems of classification are developed at a particular time. So you have to learn the different systems. Basically, there are three systems of plant classification: artificial, natural, and phylogenetic. You have to learn that systems of plant classification. And additionally, you have to learn one of the modern system of plant classification, that is a APG system in brief. Then study of plant family. You have to study the plant family. Under this, you have to study some families of Polypetalae according to Bentham and Hooker system, some families of Gamopetalae, and one family is from Petalae or Monoclamidae, and one family is from Monocotyledon. In this way, you have to learn eight families. Under this, you have to learn the eight families with respect to their morphological, reproductive characters, classification, floral diagram, floral formula, and common plants belong to that particular family. This is what about the credit first. In credit second, under botanical nomenclature, you have to get understand the concept of botanical nomenclature. What is the history of botanical nomenclature? Then you have to learn what is the binomial nomenclature system of angiosperm, identification and nomenclature. Then you have to get understand the course of international botanical nomenclature. That is what briefly said as ICBN, International Course of Botanical Nomenclature. What thing is described in the botanical nomenclature that you have to study under the botanical nomenclature. So these four topics, introduction, systems of classification, studies of families, botanical nomenclature, are belongs to taxonomy of angiosperm. This is what the first part of your paper first. Then second part of your paper first, that is what is part of plant ecology. So under that you have to first see the introduction to plant ecology. Under introduction you have to see what is definition, what is the concept of ecology, what is the scope, why the ecology is an interdisciplinary approach, what is mean by atoecology and what is mean by scene ecology. Then again, you have to learn species diversity, types of diversity, methods of vegetation sampling, genetic diversity, species diversity in detail, ecosystem diversity in detail, and one topic you have to learn under this, that is a hotspots of India, biodiversity hotspots of India. These things are included in under the introduction to plant ecology. Then in the last point, ecological grouping of the plant. Plants are also grouped ecologically on the basis of in which environments the plants are growing, and according to different types of ecological groupings of plants are made. So under this point you have to learn the ecological grouping of plants with respect to their adaptations, external and internal adaptations. And under this, you have to learn about the four ecological groups of plants, and that are what? Hydrophytes, mesophytes, xerophytes, and halophytes. The name itself includes the environmental condition. Hydrophytes means plants growing in a plenty of water. Mesophytes means plants are growing in an optimum condition of environment. Xerophytes means plants growing in a xeric condition, and halophytes means plants are growing in a marine or salty situation, salty mud or marine environment. This is what ecological grouping of the plants. So in this way, you have to complete your this course of taxonomy of angiosperm and plant ecology for the semester 3rd of SYBSC. So this is what a introduction about the taxonomy of angiosperm and plant ecology. Okay, this is a introduction to you with respect to your syllabus of botany and credits. Thank you.